because our home is our sanctuary. It's where we go at the end of the day to recharge and recruit. It's where we sleep. It's where we love our children and raise them and our spouses and cook dinner. And it's just full of us and our personalities. And I think it's so important that regardless of budget, regardless of taste, that it reflects who you are and what you love. And to demonstrate that, you know, we're at a nursery and we're outside, and thankfully we have a nice breeze. We have this table, and I'm going to do three very different looks that you all are familiar with, from the least popular to the most popular, and use that as a way to talk a little bit about design. We have food. Feel free to stop and ask questions, and I'll try to make it quick so none of us melt. We have a backdrop here just to represent a basic wall. My biggest request for everybody when we're talking about your home is that you make sure it reflects you. No one wants to walk into a home and see a hotel. We go to hotels because it's neutral and we can get away. When you want to go to your home, you want it to reflect you and say who you are and make you feel comfortable. And that's most important. The first design element I have is English cottage, which was huge in the 80s. It's very popular. And it's still very popular in New England, where I'm from. You see it in all the big homes in Connecticut and in Massachusetts. I was in Joan Kennedy's home, who people don't necessarily think of very often, except now recently as a best friend for our cousin. And Mrs. Kennedy's home looks like an English garden right out of downtown London. And it's beautiful, and lots of color, and lots of fabric, and lots of textile. And so, in honor of the Kennedys, I'm going to do the first one as an English garden. These are all fabrics that I grabbed just to demonstrate what different colors and different feelings can do and how easy it is to completely change a look using things you have in your home already. One of the biggest things about English design is it's all about textures. If any of you have ever been to Europe, especially the UK, it's cold, it's damp, it's dark. And so people want to make sure they fill their homes with lots and lots of layers of fabric. The biggest fabrics there are velvets and brocades and really heavy fabrics and also very, very light, very beautiful colors because it's dreary and it's dark. I have something very easy that anyone can do at home. You don't have to be crafty. This is a canvas, a painter's canvas. You can get it at Walmart, at Target. It costs me, I think, $9. And you can paint on it if you like to paint. You can cover it with fabric. It is the easiest way to transform. Probably $7 for at Beverly's down here in Salinas. They have Beverly's in the east side as well. And you don't have to be crafty, let me tell you, I'm not. Love. to Europe, do you bring back pieces from Europe? Let's go to Australia, you can bring back boomerang, leaving them on your wall. And all three have a place. And you need to figure out, you know, what's important to you and what you like. And it can be as simple as cloth and fabric. All of this, by the way, is here at McShane's.